day gone by?
What a wonderful camp meeting we have had yesterday and today. Wonderful song. Wonderful instrumental. We have heard testimonies, poems.
Ovoga što smo slušali ovog popodneva, prvo od pastora Luneta i od naše braće i sestara iz Ruske crkve.
And I'm still under the impression of what we have heard this morning and this afternoon from Pastor Luna and our brothers and sisters as well.
Hvala vam, veoma vam hvala na predivnom iskustvu koje ste izrazili kroz pesmu.
Thank you very much on the wonderful testimony that you have expressed through your song.
I što ste sve to izrazili na našem jeziku da pokažete da je zajedništvo ono što je još uvek tu u našim srcima.
And for expressing that in our own language just to show that the community is in your heart and our hearts.
To je bilo zaista nešto posebno za mene, a verujem za sve nas ovdje.
And that was something very special for me and I believe for all of us here today.
I ako se ikada zapitamo šta je to evanđelje, šta je to nositi Hrista svetu, šta je to crkva?
And if we ever ask ourselves what is the gospel and what is that that we need to take out to people?
To je upravo ono što smo mi osjetili u vašoj pesmi i u vašem svedočanstvu.
And that's exactly what we've experienced in your song and your testimony.
A to je zajedništvo i ljubav braći i sestara.
And that's the community and love between brothers and sisters.
Naš neprijatelj nema oružje protiv toga.
Our enemy doesn't have a weapon against that.
I sada gledam, već je 8 sati prošlo.
So I'm realizing it's past 8 o'clock.
I sa velikom tugom u srcu moram reći da je barem ovaj bogoslužbeni deo našeg sabora došao svome kraju.
And with a sadness in my heart, I need to say that our service has come to its end.
Naslov ove večerašnje teme je kao dan jučerašnji kad mine.
And the title of tonight's sermon is when the yesterday comes to its close.
Tako i ovaj sabor je došao svome kraju.
So this sabor approached its end.
30 godina postojanja ove crkve se navršila.
30 years of the existence of this church have come to not really an end, but we reach that point in time.
A kamoli neće jedan sabor od 2-3 dana.
In the same way, a 2 or 3 day long convocation comes to its end.
Naslov ove naše kratke teme je preuzet iz Psalma 90. stih 4.
The title of this sermon was taken from Psalm 90 verse 4.
Poslednji deo četvrtog stiha kaže kao dan jučerašnji kad mine i to je psalam o kratkotrajnosti i prolaznosti ljudskog života.
So the last part of the verse 4 says are like yesterday when it is past.
Dakle, ne samo jedan sabor, ne samo jedan jubilej prođe kao dan jučerašnji.
Not only that one sabor or one jubilee passes like the yesterday.
Psalmista kaže da ceo život prođe kao dan jučerašnji.
Psalmist says that the whole life passes like the yesterday.
I nekako što smo stariji, to nam ove reči zvuče istinitije.
And as we are getting older, these words are sounding like more accurate.
Ne znam da li ste ikada čuli za takozvanu kapućinsku crkvu.
I don't know if you have ever heard about a Capuchin church.
Ova crkva nalazi se u Rimu i potiče iz 17. veka.
And this church is located in Rome and it dates from the 11th century. 17th yeah. century, I'm sorry.
Ova crkva postala je poznato hodočasničko mesto i turističko mesto zahvaljujući kripti koja se nalazi ispod crkve.
And this place has become a place of pilgrimage because of something that's under the church, a crypt.
Mm-hmm. I koja se nalazi ispod crkve. Ova kripta ukrašena je, svi zidovi, čak i plafoni crkve, ukrašeni su ornamentima načinjenih od ljudskih kostiju.
And this crypt is decorated with the ornaments that are made from human bones.
Kasnije možete da googlujete ovu crkvu na internetu, premda možda je bolje da pogledate slike ujutru, nije dobro baš pred spavanje gledati.
Later on you can google up this church, but I advise you to look at it in the morning, not before you go to sleep.
Dakle, ova kripta čuva posmrtne ostatke od preko 4000 kapućinskih monaha.
So this crypt preserved the remnants of people, remains, thank you, bodily remains of people, all monks who have passed away who belong to that church.
I neki skeleti su sačuvani u celini.
And some of the skeletons are preserved in its wholeness.
Dakle, kada to mesto zaista predstavlja jednu vrstu morbidne umetnosti.
So that place is a place of morbid art.
Ono što je interesantno jeste jedna ploča koja sadrži sledeću poruku.
What is interesting is one plate that contains the following message.
Na nekoliko jezika.
In several languages.
I poruka glasi.
And the message says.
Ono što si ti sada.
What you are now.
Mi smo nekada bili.
We have been sometimes in the past.
Ono što smo mi sada.
What we are now.
Ti ćeš jednog dana biti.
You will become. One day.
I ovo je jedan zaista prosto zastrašujući sažetak prolaznosti ljudskog života.
And this is one petrifying summary of a human life.
I mnoge ljude koji posete to mesto navodi na duboko razmišljanje o smislu života.
And many people who visit that place are prompting to think about deep things of life and its purpose.
Kako živim svoj život? Gde su moji prioriteti?
How do I live my life? Where are my priorities?
Psalm 90 govori puno o toj temi.
Psalm 90 talks a lot about that topic.
Prvi i drugi stih kažu: Gospode, ti si nam utočište od kolena do kolena. Prije nego se gore rodiše i sazda se zemlja i vasiljena i od veka i do veka ti si Bog.
First two verses read, Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even you had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting you are God.
Bog je od kolena do kolena, od veka do veka.
So God was their God from one to another generation, from one to another century.
I Božja večnost čini da naš život izgleda još prolazniji.
And God's eternity makes our life seem even more transient.
Četvrti stih kaže, jer je tisuća godina pred očima tvojima kao dan jučerašnji kad mine i kao straža noćna.
Verse 4 says, for a thousand years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past. And like a watch in the night.
1000 godina za Boga je ne samo kao dan jučerašnji kad mine, nego kao straža noćna.
So a thousand years for God is not just the day like yesterday, but like a watch in the night.
U biblijska vremena ljudi su delili noć u zavisnosti od godišnjeg doba na tri ili četiri straže.
So in the biblical times, people would divide up the night time according to three or four night watches.
Tako da jedna noćna straža otprilike traje 3 do 4 sata.
So one night watch would last from 3 to 4 hours.
Dakle, poetski rečeno za Boga je 1000 godina kao 3-4 sata.
So poetically speaking for God, 1000 years is like 3 to 4 hours.
I onda dalje psalam kaže 5. i 6. stih, ti ih kao povodnjem odnosiš, misleći na dane čovekove, one su kao san, kao trava koja rano vene, ujutru cveta i uvene i uveče se pokosi i sasuši.
You carry them away like a flood, they are like a sleep. In the morning they are like grass which grows up. In the morning it flourishes and grows up. In the evening it is cut down and withers.
Posljednji deo 9. stiha kaže, godine naše prolaze kao glas.
Last part of verse 9 says, we finish our years like a sigh.
I ovdje u jevrejskom jeziku ovo kao glas zapravo znači kao uzdah.
In the Hebrew scripture it says like a sigh.
Kao jednom kad se udahne i izdahne, izgleda da je prošao ceo život u tom jednom dahu.
It seems like a life passes like when you inhale and exhale, it goes that fast.
10. stih, posljednji deo 10. stiha kaže za naše dane, jer teku brzo i mi odlećemo.
The last part of the verse 10 says about our days, for it is soon cut off and we fly away.
Kada prođe jedan životni vek, izgleda kao ptica koja je odlepršala.
When the human life passes away, it looks like a bird flying away.
I zaista kada razmišljamo o ovome i kada vidimo ka čemu idemo i gdje je naš kraj,
and when we think about this and we see where we are heading to and what is our end.
Psalmista kaže da naš vek nije samo kratkotrajan i prolazan.
Psalmist says that our life is not only short and transient.
10. stih kaže i sam cvijet, odnosno snaga ili plod njihov je muka i nevolja.
Verse 10 says that even its own flower or a fruit is a struggle and suffering.
Dakle, ne samo da je kratak ovaj život, nego je ispunjen mnogim nevoljama.
Not only this life is short, but it's filled with many obstacles and suffering.
I da li znamo odgovor na pitanje zašto je to tako?
Do we know the answer to this question? Why is that?
Da li je to bila Božja namera?
Was that God's plan?
Kada je stvarao svet?
When he was creating the world?
Nije. Ja vjerujem da svi znamo odgovor na to pitanje zašto je to tako. Ali psalmista to podcrtava za sve nas i kaže u 7. i 8. stihu, jer nas nestaje od gneva tvojega i od jarosti tvoje u smetnji smo, stavio si bezakonja naša predase i tajne naše na svetlost lica svojega.
We know that that wasn't God's plan, as verse 7 and 8 exclaim, for we have been consumed by your anger and by your wrath. We are terrified. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your countenance.
Greh je taj koji je doveo do toga da je život kratak i pun nevolje.
Sin is what brought about a shortness of life and it being filled with suffering.
I to su neke činjenice koje i verujući i neverujući ljudi moraju da se slože.
And those are facts of life that even the believing and unbelieving people have to accept.
Svi znamo da je život kratak i ispunjen nevoljama.
We all know that life is short and it's filled with struggle.
Ali razlika između verujućih i neverujućih je u tome kako će se postaviti prema tom egzistencijalnom problemu.
But the difference between believers and unbelievers is how they will approach this existential question.
Jedan stav je opisan u Isaiji 22. poglavlju 13. stihu koji kaže jedimo i pijmo jer ćemo, šta? Sutra umreti.
One type of attitude is described by in the book of Isaiah, which says, "Let us eat and drink because we're going to die tomorrow."
Drugi stav je ono što psalmista nas poziva da usvojimo mi u svom životu.
Different type of attitude is what Isaiah is calling us to accept in our life.
11. i 12. stih kažu.
11 and 12. Oh, it's same psalm?
U psalmu 90. Da.
Okay, so Psalm 90, verses 11 and 12.
Ko zna silu gnjeva tvojega i tvoju jarost da bi te se bojao kao što treba?
Who knows the power of your anger, for as the fear of you, so is your wrath?
Ko zna silu gneva tvojega? Ovo je jedno retoričko pitanje zato što niko od ljudi zaista ne poznaje svu jarost i silinu Božjeg gneva prema grehu.
Who knows the power of your anger? That's actually a rhetorical question because none of us really have experienced that.
I to je samo zato što je Isus Hristos na krstu preuzeo taj gnev na sebe.
And that's only because Jesus accepted on the cross that wrath upon himself.
I ovde stih kaže da bi te se bojao kao što treba.
And here verse says so that I would fear you as I should, as it is appropriate.
Zato što postoji strah prema Bogu kako ne treba.
Because there is a fear towards God that's not appropriate.
I strah Boži, poštovanje Boga kako treba.
And fear and respect, that's good.
E ovaj strah kako treba je opisan u 12. stihu koji kaže: nauči nas tako brojati dane naše da bismo stekli srce mudro.
So this positive type of fear is this described in verse 12, which says, so teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom.
Svi mi brojimo dane u svom životu.
All of us are counting days in our lives.
Slavimo rođendane.
We celebrate birthdays.
Obeležavamo godišnjice.
Anniversaries.
I proslavljamo jubileje kao što je ovaj jubilej 30. godišnjice crkve u Sakramentu.
And we celebrate jubilees like this one.
Ali Bog ne želi od nas samo da brojimo dane, nego da ih brojimo tako da steknemo srce mudro.
But God doesn't want us just to count days, but he wants us to count them in a way to develop a wise heart.
U biblijskom smislu brojati dane znači živeti sa svešću da ceo naš život pred očima velikog sudije i suverenog Boga.
So in the biblical sense, to count days is to live with awareness of God and the judgment day that
and
is approaching.
And the judgment day of God. Na primer, u Danilu 5. Glavi 26. stihu.
So for example, in the book of Daniel 5:26.
Brzo ćemo pročitati samo taj jedan stih.
I'm going to read it quickly.
To je jedan primer toga šta to znači brojati dane.
And that's an example of what it means to count the
days. I kako je to povezano sa Božjim sudom.
And how is that connected with God's judgment?
Peta glava, 26. stih knjige proroka Danila kaže.
So Daniel 5:26.
A ovo znače te reči: brojio je Bog tvoje carstvo i do kraja izbrojio.
This is the interpretation of each word. God has numbered your kingdom and finished it.
Dakle, to je proces suda koji za ovog cara, nažalost, nije bio pozitivan.
So that's the process of judgment that wasn't positive for this king.
Zato što ako se sećate petog poglavlja Danila, ovaj car je živeo onaj način života jedimo i pijemo jer ćemo sutra umreti.
Because if you remember the book of Daniel, then you know that this king lived according to those words, let us eat and drink because we're going to die tomorrow.
Te kada je bio izmeren na merila, našao se lak.
When he was weighed on the scale, he was found a light.
Nemamo vremena čitati stihove iz Jova, knjige o Jovu, gde kažu, na primjer, 14. poglavlje, da je Bog brojio dane Jovove.
Job chapter 14 says that God counted Job's days.
Ali za razliku od cara Valtazara u knjizi proroka Danila, koji se našao lak,
but it's different from what we find in the book of Daniel, where the king was found light.
Job je onaj koji je imao suštinu života pred Bogom.
Job is the one who had an essence of life before God.
I prošao je test Božijeg suda.
And he passed the test of God's judgment.
Dakle, braći i sestre, dok budemo sada brojali dane u susret novoj godišnjici, novom jubileju.
So brothers and sisters, as we will be counting the days, looking ahead towards the new jubilee and celebration.
Hajde da brojimo naše dane tako da steknemo srce mudro.
Let us count our days so that we would gain wisdom.
Tako da kada Gospod bude merio naša dela, da nas nađe teškim.
So when God starts weighing our acts, that he would find us heavy.
To možda izazove u nama sada jednu neizvesnost i strah, pa kako ćemo mi to uspeti?
So this maybe creates some uncertainty and fear, because we're thinking how are we going to achieve that?
90. psalam završava se s jednom pozitivnom notom, punom nade.
Psalm 90 ends with one positive emphasis that's filled with hope.
Čitaćemo stihove 14. do 17.
So verses from 14 to 17.
Ujutru nas nasiti dobrote svoje i radovat ćemo se i veseliti u sve dane svoje. Obraduj nas prema danima i prema godinama u koje smo gledali nevolju. 14. i 15.
O, satisfy us early with your mercy that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Make us glad according to the days in which you have afflicted us, the years in which we have seen evil.
I 16. i 17. stih. Neka se pokaže na slugama tvojim delo tvoje i slava tvoja na sinovima njihovim.
And verses 16 and 17, let your works appear to your servants and your glory to their children, and let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us and establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands.
Neka bude dobra volja Gospoda Boga našega s nama i delo ruku naših dovrši nam. I delo ruku naših dovrši nam.
Okay, I translated that twirl.
Ovde je jedno obećanje za sve nas.
There is a promise here for all of us.
Da će se Božja slava pokazati na nama.
That God's glory will be revealed through us.
Da će njegova blagodat nas obasjati.
That his grace will shine upon us.
I da će nas ta blagodat osposobiti da živimo mudro naše dane.
And that grace will equip us to live wisely all the days of our lives.
I obećanje je da će dobra volja Gospoda Boga našega dovršiti delo ruku naših.
And the promise is that the good will of God will accomplish the works of our hands.
Ako su dela naša dobra i pravedna,
if our works are good and righteous,
na dobrobit drugih i na slavu Bogu,
for the benefit of others and to the glory of God,
obećanje je da će dobra volja Boga našega dovršiti delo ruku naših.
The promise is that a good will of God will finish the work of our hands.
To je obećanje koje Bog dao ljudima koji su započeli graditi ovu crkvenu zajednicu pre 30 godina.
That's the promise that God extended to people who started this community 30 years ago.
I to je obećanje koje Bog potvrđuje večeras svima nama.
And that's the promise that God is confirming tonight for all of us.
Nastavite delo Božije verujući da će slava njegova biti nad vama.
Continue the work of God believing that his glory will be upon you.
I kada se nekada čini da je nešto dolazi svome kraju,
and when sometimes seems that something is approaching its end,
kao što je kraj života,
like it is with the end of life,
u Isusu Hristu, u njegovoj blagodati, to je samo jedan novi početak.
In Jesus Christ and his grace, that is only a new beginning.
Bog ne zna za kraj.
God doesn't know for the end.
Jer je on večan i milost njegova je večna.
Because he is eternal and his mercy is eternal.
Želela bih na kraju da ostavim ovo obećanje iz Otkrivenja svima vama.
At the end, I'd like to share the promise from the book of Revelation with you.
14. poglavlje, 13. stih.
Chapter 14, verse 13.
I čuh glas neba gde mi govori, napiši. Blago mrtvima koji umiru u Gospodu od sad. Da, govori Duh, da počinu od trudova svojih, jer dela njihova idu za njima.
Then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, Write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works follow them.
Za našeg Gospoda ni smrt nije kraj.
For our Lord, even death is not an end.
Jer postoji obećanje da naša dela idu za nama.
Because there is a promise that our works are following us.
To je obećanje vaskrsenja.
And that's the promise about resurrection.
Kada će oni koji su umrli u Gospodu dobiti krunu i nagradu koju im je Gospod pripremio.
When those who died in the Lord will receive the reward and the crown that God has prepared for them.
A za nas koji smo još uvek živi,
and for us who are still alive,
to je jedno ohrabrenje da nastavimo dobro delo u Božjem delu.
That's an encouragement to continue doing good works within God's work.
Jer će jednoga dana i ta dela nas pratiti kada odemo ka Gospodu.
Because one day those works will follow us as we are going to back to God.
Kao dan jučerašnji kad mine,
like yesterday when it is past,
nije pesimistička poruka.
It's not a pessimistic message.
Zato što u Hristu imamo život večni.
Because in Christ we have eternal life.
Pa kad nam je Gospod dao večni život, kako neće dati budućnost ovoj crkvi i ovoj zajednici?
So when God gave us eternal life, how wouldn't he give the future to this community and this church?
Neka nas Gospod blagoslovi da se sretnemo za 60-godišnjicu crkve u Sakramentu.
May God bless us so that we would meet for the 60th anniversary of the church in Sacramento.
I ako Bog da da budemo živi i zdravi tada, sigurna sam da ćemo reći da su proteklih 30 godina prošli kao dan jučerašnji kad mine.
And when we meet, I'm sure that we would say that days had passed away like the yesterday when it's passed.
Neka je hvala i slava Gospodu na svemu.
May God's name be glorified forever.
Amen.
And if that happens in 60 years, then you come back.
I promise.
Sveto Dragoslav, hvala ti puno na ovoj poruci ohrabrenja.
So, Sister Dragoslava, thank you very much on this message of encouragement.
Naše večerašnje bogosluženje završit ćemo sa pesmom crkvenog hora.
Our tonight service we will finish with a song by our Sabor choir.
Pevajmo složno.
Let us sing together.
I posle toga će se doktor Dragoslava Santoš pomoliti sa nama, ali dok hor bude izlazio, ja bih zamolila đakone da sakupe dar.
So I invite deacons as the members of the choirs are coming forward, I'm asking them to collect the offering.
Ustanemo za molitvu. Gospode i Bože naš, ti koji si nam dao tu privilegiju da te zovemo svojim ocem, Oče naš nebeski, neka je hvala i slava tebi od veka i do veka, od svih srca naših, Gospode, za sva dobra tvoja dela koja si nam učinio, za sve blagoslove tvoje i za nadu koju imamo, da gledamo u budućnost ne sa strahom, nego sa poverenjem i sa radošću, jer znamo, Gospode, da si ti Bog naš i da si sa nama. Gospode, po obećanju Tvojemu, blagoslovi i dovrši dela ruku naših. Gospode, želimo da dela ruku naših budu pravedna i dobra, da budu istinita, da budu vredna u Tvojim očima. Da nosimo Hrista svetu, da objavimo vest Evanđelja svetu koji to treba da čuje, te da još mnogi postanu deo Tvoga naroda, te da se naše slave i hvale umnožavaju pred Tobom. I Gospode, dok sada budemo odlazili u večernji deo, na večeru, na druženje, neka duh Tvoje radosti, duh Tvoga mira bude nad nama. I za sutrašnji dan, Gospode, kada se budemo družili, neka Tvoja radost počiva nad nama. i u dane koji dolaze neka slava Tvoja počiva nad nama. O Gospode, da jednoga dana možemo reći da, Gospode, neka dela ruku naših, neka dela naše idu za nama, jer su u Tebi učinjena. Neka je slava i hvala Tebi, neka blagoslov Tvoj bude nad nama, na našim porodicama, nad našim mladima i starima, na onima u srednjim godinama, nad našim crkvama, Gospode. Neka bude slava Tvoja nad svima nama. U Isusovo ime Te molimo i zahvaljujemo se. Amin.
Amin.
Samo par trenutaka vas molim.
I just want to ask you for a few more moments of attention.
Jel da smo imali divan dan? Hvala Gospodu za ovaj dan. Hvala vama da ste bili u ovom danu sa nama.
Don't you agree that we have had a wonderful day and thank you for being with us?
Samo još